So the value of DNSC lies in the fact that you are not just servicing or giving network services to a single OEM. You can actually, with a centralized platform, give services across, whether it is provisioning, analytics, insight into multitude of platforms using DNSC. The importance of DNSC being an open platform, it gives us, a partner like us, the ability to create solutions and extend and develop beyond DNSC. I'm going to show you a demo of how do you onboard a third-party device using DNSC. What we've done is also integrated this with an ITSM platform, in our case it's ServiceNow, in which you can essentially go open up a ticket and you can actually provision these Juniper devices using just one GUI, which is the ITSM platform. All you need to do is log in into a ServiceNow platform, and using your ServiceNow platform, you can configure the entire device. So what you see on the screen is, let's say you have a caller ID, you go ahead and say, I want to go ahead and actually do a provisioning exercise. So you select DNSC provisioning. Now once you select the DNSC provisioning, all you need to do is enter the IP address of the device. Once you enter the IP address of the device, this is a Juniper device IP address, by the way. You say, what kind of configuration do you want? Do you want an OSPF configuration? So you go define you say, I want to do an OSPF configuration, and then define what interface, what is the priority level of that configuration, what do you want to do from an OSPF priority standpoint. You just enter those parameters and enter a short description. So what you see on the screen is OSPF area, OSPF priority, and router ID being entered. Now once you enter the short description and you essentially say OSPF configuration, and then you click on submit, what then happens is that you get a ServiceNow ticket created. Once you see the ticket being created, essentially it then talks in backend. So what you see on the screen is a ticket being created. So if you see, there is a ticket that has been created. It's a fresh OSPF device configuration ticket. Now what it does is essentially, in the backend, it logs in, the ServiceNow integration with NetBot logs into NetBot, and it creates an event triggered job for it. Now, if you see the event triggered job, you see it is success, which essentially means the device configuration has been pushed into the Juniper device. So just to validate whether this has been done, we log into the device. This is a Juniper device for all of you, what you see on the screen, and essentially try and verify whatever configuration we had entered in ServiceNow gets replicated in the device itself. So what you see, we do a show protocol, which essentially gives us the IP routed protocol's information, and you see that information that we'd entered is already there in the router itself. So no login into CLI, all of this is done through the GUI itself. Once it is done, you've verified whether everything is okay, it goes a step further and closes the ITSM ticket on its own as well. And once you've done the closure of the ticket, it also publishes a map. We've done a third-party integration for that, so that you can see in your network topology where does the device lie, how is the routing working, etc. So what you see on the screen is that it is already resolved, and it is now going ahead and closing the ServiceNow ticket. Please visit the Cisco DNA Center Ecosystem Exchange to learn more about our solutions and to contact us.